Hello there, everyone, and welcome to a re-recording of the final episode of the 358 over 2 days movie, because I forgot to download the commentary idle audio from the server it was stored on, and then it got deleted because it's not stored locally. Anyways, I am, of course, the Nomadic Ark, and I have with me, as always, Selegna.
Hello.
I have Valdorian.
Hello.
And I have two new voices. I have Maverick. Well, Maverick ain't so new, but hello, Maverick.
Now in stereo.
And I have the new voice, Mighty Master.
Hello.
All right, now, let's go ahead and jump into this. Now, Mighty Master, do you have any questions before we jump into this?
Not particularly, no.
Okay, because you're coming in at the end. I hope you
absolutely
know a lot about.
And if you join me tomorrow, you're coming in halfway, halfway through the game.
All right, let's go.
Oh yeah, no. I'm looking at the timestamps.
Looks like you've meddled again.
And yeah, so I only have three more episodes, something? And given what I've done, it should be pretty easy to do it now.
Just one suffice.
Stop. I want to let everybody know how it took me about, I had to pay attention to this movie for about, like, close to an hour and a half or more to make sure that I paused the movie at the right point. So it would load up with day 353. And the even more fun thing is that my controller actually died halfway through watching the movie, so I had to figure out how to control it with the keyboard. Because I forgot what the keyboard controls were.
Shield, stop!
Ultimate excitement, right there.
Of all the faces, why do I look at her and see yours? Why is it that you always
forget foreshadowing?
It's that guy.
Shut up.
It's even weirder if you've played 358 over 2, because that's the first time you ever see this character.
Yep.
Because 358 over 2 came out before Birth by Sleep.
I'm sorry.
Also, it's explained how that happened. What are you It doing? Is explained how Shion was able to beat Zaldin, one of the strongest in the organization.
I have to do this
in
else.
Your playthrough?
Just look.
No, in the Ultimania.
How'd she fight him then?
You know what her power is, right?
Please, Axel. You have to take care of Roxas.
No.
But
that's
no.
Zemnis.
What's her power?
She's a blue mage.
Please.
Oh wait, so she stole his guns?
She stole his speed.
Thank you, Axel.
Is Zigbar known for being fast?
He controls space and time.
Explain yourself, Axel.
Did you forget about that?
Man needs to get I forgot that's what his.
Remember, he could. Remember, when you actually have a boss fight with him, he warps the arena to fit his needs.
Now we're left with the one we.
Oh yeah, and then also creates a sniper's perk for himself.
Happen?
And walks on the ceiling. And thin air.
He's having a lot of fun, okay?
Literally, Xion is a uber powerful blue mage. She steals the powers of whoever she is facing.
Okay, that makes a little more sense as to why it was saying that she was designed to copy Roxas's powers.
Yes, but she was bugged because she was a prototype. She copied everyone's powers if she was around them long enough as she learned how to use them.
You could say she's more of Rogue from the X-Men.
Oh yeah, yeah. Just without the killing you part.
Really?
Yeah.
Nothing?
All the benefits of Rogue without the downside.
Mm-hmm.
How can that be nothing?
It's just like Zigbar said.
That would actually
also, there is no way Axel could have stopped Shion.
Run away.
What's Axel's power?
I'm asking you why you did.
No, she still had Zigbar's power at that point.
What I understand from what you're saying, even if Axel took her on by himself, she would win.
To duplicate your powers.
Is that correct?
Nuts.
Yes.
A person.
What's Axel's power?
Control
She's
over flames.
That reflects you.
But then that would mean he would absorb them too, wouldn't
no,
it?
No, She'd be able to control his.
She could take his away, and he wouldn't be able to be me.
She would have his power, so if she tried to, if he tried to throw his chakrams at her, she'd just send him right back.
They have to destroy her?
She's a mirror.
Answer me!
She can't! Xeon cast reflect! It's super effective.
If somebody doesn't, then you won't be you anymore.
I'll always be me. I'm still your best friend.
He says that he'll just always be him, but that's not always true.
But hey, that's not how that works.
You're missing the whole point, Roxas.
Forget this, Roxas!
I wish you'd understand, Roxas.
I wish he would too.
Comprehension is hard.
Riku.
Did you find the answer?
Yes.
Did you find the answer? That's a good question. I don't know.
I'm on the verge of losing everything I care about. So please. Please, Riku. Tell me what I should do now.
Go to Twilight Town. You'll find a girl there named Naminé.
Naminé? What's she like?
You'll find out.
It's a bit I don't think batty, a bit...
Excuse me.
A bit blonde, a bit airheaded, but I think you'll get along great.
Goodbye.
She's really good at drawing pictures. I know you're into that stuff. Have a good time.
They just hang out. They just hang out drawing together all day. You see? No, that's what she steals from Naminé—the ability to draw.
She can't steal from Naminé. She cannot steal from Naminé.
Why not?
Shion has disappeared.
Naminé's not a real nobody. Again.
Do we know where she is headed?
I guess
it's
that's right.
Not she given is the a replica.
Given her unique circumstances.
Given that who a she came from.
She's what does that basically mean? Can I say this? I'm not sure if this would be considered spoilers. Because we know who Rocks somebody is.
The whatka?
Well, we know what hers, who hers is. We know who
yes,
is.
She's basically Sora and Kairi's kid.
The purpose was to take a piece of the Keyblade.
If you really want to put that much thought into it, yes.
Because she was born when Sora stabbed himself. Because he freed Kairi's heart at the same time. But the weird thing is, Naminé shouldn't even exist because Princesses of Heart have no darkness, and nobody is formed from the darkness of the, when the Heartless are formed.
That's why Naminé's special, Selenia. Jeez.
Yeah.
Follow along.
Oh, speaking of Nomura's batshit plot, did you know he's the one who wanted Final Fantasy VII Remake to stay the same plot?
Formed an identity of its own.
I mean, what it was pretty batshit plot to begin with, let's be real.
He wanted the plot to stay the same. It was Katase who wanted the new plot.
Do you concur? Axel.
Well, we'll see where it goes in the sequel.
Yeah. There are some plot points I want them to hit, but I'm not sure they will anymore.
I'm sure they'll do broad strokes, it's just the minutiae is going to be a little bit different. Still, which I'm excited for that kind of stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Very, like, Rashomon style.
Definitely.
What exactly do you...
Also, people are worried about the Crisis Core remake having a different combat style, and I'm like, the combat style of the original fucking sucked.
Yeah, it wasn't great.
Didn't like that.
It's because it had half the buttons of a PlayStation controller. It didn't even have a joystick.
Yeah, it had an analog thumb.
It had an analog thumbstick for movement. You could control the camera.
Yeah, I'm excited to have a game that actually plays well as being pretty cool. Axel. The main thing is, we better still get that email about how much shampoo Sephiroth uses. Very important. That people remember that.
Bring her back.
About shampoos?
I'm kind of worried about how they figured that out. How the fan club figured that out.
Don't worry about it.
So, fun fact. That's Zigbar. That's Zaldin's only voiced line in the entire game.
And he's done.
That's literally Zaldin's only voiced line in the entire game.
Same with him.
Demix, Luxord, and Zaldin all have one voice line. It focuses on The ones who have the most voice are Syax, Axel, Roxas. Shion, and Roxas.
Proceed with your mission.
Thymnus is right up there, though. Like, not as many as much as them, but
she's not.
But
a
he has more than the other three.
Could be part of the organization. Just count the seats here. We have, and always will be, 13.
Yeah, no, Shion was number 14.
Axel.
We have and always will be 13 because Nomura, for some reason, has a hard-on for the number 20?
No, he just has a... Here's something funny. You know Ars Arcanum, right? Back to
the organization. It sounds familiar?
The limit in Kingdom Hearts 1? Do what Zemnis
says. Oh, yeah.
Well, crits exist in Kingdom Hearts 1. They'll eradicate there are two hits guaranteed on Ars Arcanum.
In that case, can you at least try not to harm her?
There are... The crits that are guaranteed on Ars Arcanum are hit 7 and hit 13.
Shion is dangerous.
Nice.
Dangerous?
So he's been doing this since Kingdom Hearts 1. Your strength
back. Yeah, I guess he has. That's just so weird.
He's got some weird upset because 7 and 13 are considered holy numbers.
Could it be
7 days in the week?
That you've known about her for a long time and not
then
told me.
Then where's 13 at?
13 is just considered a lucky number in the Bible. I don't know where it came that it was an unlucky number.
Mouse in a coat. If you give a mouse a coat, will it want a hood?
Okay. Where'd that question come from?
Because Mickey's ears somehow fit in the hood.
I was gonna say, if you give a mouse a cookie, will it want some milk?
Hey, look! Yeah. It's Ansem.
Yeah, Mickey knows what to do there. Summon the blade!
Also, fun fact, does Mickey have voice lines in this version?
I think he does here.
Yeah, so it did expand this a little bit from the DS release. Riku!
Your there majesty. We go.
Yeah, that worried about you, Mickey does not speak in this scene time? In the game.
I've been.
We haven't gotten to this scene in your playthrough, have we?
No, we have not. We're almost there. While we wait for Sora. You want to know why Mickey doesn't speak in the scene in the game? The way you
look. Because it goes.
They had it replaced. No, they hadn't replaced his voice actor after
I'm
dying.
The hang of keeping the darkness under control.
So this is just a text box scene, then.
Did something go wrong with fixing all his memories?
Is that what you're saying?
Is there a text box, or it might just cut off after...
This scene does not exist in the game. This part right here. Members had made them weak.
Taking Sora's memory apart, piece by piece, was only the first step in what they were trying to do at Castle Oblivion. And I think they needed more time to fix his memory.
You know, what you and me were.
Shouldn't this have already been explained to Mickey at Castle Oblivion?
Like this doesn't like explaining shit.
Like they're trying to buy some time.
Well, I guess so. Because it seems like. Right. Actually, because now that I think about it, it seems like Riku had to figure this out on his own. Are what
they're after. Mm-hmm.
And I would imagine that Diz already knew. Until now,
to absorb. Oh, yeah, Diz knew. Namine is the one who told Riku.
Yeah, so Riku had to figure this out on his own.
But Diz knew the whole time. Diz knew the whole time.
Diz is a dick. Well, then you have to let Diz is a foolish dick because he's
even more of a foolish dick when we get to Kingdom Hearts 2.
I know, because he should have seen a majority of what was happening. I think his problem is that he doesn't like to see the forest for the trees, so to speak.
One of the organization's members soon.
If you've heard of that saying.
Not survive the fight.
I have not.
And if I basically, did, he has a very narrow scope. He has tunnel vision. That means
his whole thing is I need to fix the mistakes of the organization. Donald and
Goofy. Yeah, and he takes the most narrow scope on doing that. Can
guide them. Oh yeah. Awaken.
So he doesn't take the time to take a step back and say.
Maybe I should get more help.
Maybe I'm not doing this the right way.
Why did these things happen? Let's just address the symptoms and not the cause.
Now.
I'll do it in the most cryptic way possible.
Yeah, he has an issue with that.
Shion.
To go left, replica you must first program. Go right. Kingdom Hearts.
Okay. There's a lot to be said for would Kingdom Hearts 3 have happened the same way it did if Diz had actually put more forethought into his actions.
When Shion left the organization, Axel didn't stop her.
Because if Diz had stopped to think about how Roxas could help them instead of just probably known about taking Rock trying to take Roxas and Shion out of the equation, it probably could have gone a lot smoother. And Master Xehanort would have not had his... Actually, I think it's kind of funny, because I think Master Xehanort planned on Diz being an idiot. Was a
replica. He did, yes.
Master Xehanort planned on a lot of things.
What about me? Am I a puppet too? Xemnas said...
Well, we'll learn more about Master Xehanort next year, I think. It'll probably be the second game that we do next year.
But who... is Sora. And who am I supposed to be? Axel, if he's hiding things from me about Shion, what could he be hiding about me?
Hey, Roxas.
Did you find Shion yet?
You know it.
God, the other side, the other promise is really good.
It is a really
yes,
good
it
track.
Is. It's Roxas's theme, isn't it?
I do believe it is.
Yeah.
Have you known?
Also, it's associated with Riku for a little bit too, but mostly Roxas.
No, not the whole.
Yeah,
team.
It's the reason. It's the reason since that it's the song that plays when you fight him in Cage too.
I can't exactly remember when.
Yep.
Didn't get it memorized, huh?
That's actually a fun fight.
Hard fight. Harder when you do the data fight.
Oh yeah.
Who am I really?
Okay, so Riku's theme is literally called Riku.
I'm special like Shion. Nice. I know that.
That seems appropriate for him.
It's literally called Riku.
Straight to the point. Right?
Yeah. They did.
Seems like Riku. Seems like something Riku would say. Like, yeah, this is my theme. I'm just gonna name it after myself.
And they didn't need me anymore. Shion has a varied version of the other promise as her theme. The same way.
You're wrong there.
A remix is the word you would use.
No, it's not remixed. It's entirely different.
Who am I, Axel?
It's a different. It's the same song, just different pitch.
That is the definition of a remix.
Ah, okay. Her theme is called "The Fading Memory."
You're different from Shion.
Then why do
finding out the truth? That's kind of dark.
Does it always work out for the best? What makes you?
You notice Axel is showing emotion here.
To know the truth.
Oh yeah.
How did I even get here?
He doesn't know it. He doesn't realize it though.
There's no greater context for what that actually is.
Yeah, it's very good brainwashing, I will tell him that.
And there's only one reason Axel developed a heart, and it's standing in front of him.
Yeah. I will give Xemnas props. He is a master brainwasher.
He's a master manipulator.
Yeah, and...
Like, the entire games, from the beginning, were all his plan. He knew exactly what was going to happen.
I can't.
Well, Roxas. Because he was told by Xehanort.
Xehanort told himself.
Yeah, so, but if I can't that makes, here, that that turns Xemnas into a really good manipulator and a really good, and becomes really good at the practice of brainwashing.
Yeah, there's something I want to explain about Xemnas, but I can't yet.
Corrupting, yeah, would probably be a good term for it, yeah.
I want to say something about Xemnas, but I can't till we play Birth by Sleep.
But I have to find out about myself.
Then I guess you'll have to hold it in until then.
There's no reason for me to be here.
Don't worry, it's only another 7 months.
No, it'll be even longer, because this isn't explained. Wait, what's the order you're supposed to go in?
I'm doing KH2 and then Bay.
No, I meant for Birth by Sleep. What's the order you're supposed
EBA.
To go in?
EBA. TVA.
Okay, so right after we finish the first story, I can explain it.
Your mind's made up?
Oh, wait, no, I can't until we get to the secret story. Choose me? The original true ending that wasn't in Final Mix.
You can't turn on the organization. You get on their
I love how they cut out Syax's fight here. Me.
There's a fight with Syax here?
That's but yeah, true. That's how Roxas got out of the castle that never was. He beat the shit out of Syax.
Well, it seems appropriate. Roxas is... If Roxas really lets loose, he could easily be considered more powerful than Syax. I mean, he by nature dual wields keyblades. And no matter what you say, you'll never convince me that two is greater than one, regardless of the sword that Syax wields.
Are you able
that claymore
to
isn't...
see my face?
There is a sword that's better than that. It's called Two Become One.
What do you think I should do?
I'm just saying that Syax's claymore, no matter how big it is, I mean, you're gonna get two
There is a reason that Keyblade is strong, though.
First, I just wanted to be with Roxas.
The Two Become One?
Yeah, because it's Two Become One.
It's literally a mix of Keyblades.
Would you say it's a final mix?
Yes, because you can only get Two Become One in Final Mix.
You're not Roxas.
Correct.
Your Kairi is sore remembers her.
Yeah, Kairi has some weird circumstances, but then she doesn't get jack shit.
As I remember more of the past,
even in her own game, she doesn't get anything.
I am really hoping that with Sora being stuck
so you're going in, Sora?
Wherever he is in Kingdom Hearts 4.
Yeah, I can't remember the name of the town.
Then you will disappear.
I can't
Quadratum! Quadratum!
Yeah.
With Sora being stuck in Quadratum, I am really hoping Kairi gets some action. Gets to...
Well, given who her trainer is...
For all the powers I possess.
You mean the only Keyblade master aside from Riku?
The memory called you.
Yes.
I know.
The only Keyblade master that didn't fuck up hard.
Otherwise, I wouldn't be here.
Well, the other two aren't masters.
I'm referring to the other Keyblade masters, not them.
Not yet.
Oh, okay.
I know. Roxas can't feel so
basically lost. Every Keyblade master, but this one fucked up real hard.
Will you please?
Well, even Kairi's master didn't make the wisest of decisions.
You won't be alone.
No.
There just isn't.
You really didn't. I mean, there's a couple of times where you could have said, "Well, you could have done that better by doing it another way."
Thank you. Well, if you're ready. Let's go see Sora.
You know, is it ever explained how Diz can use the corridors of darkness?
The organization has found us.
Is darkness in Zero? Jeez.
His name.
Yeah, that name is only explained in the Ultimania.
See what you get for trusting it.
I can handle this.
No, you can't.
Wait! Shion!
Well, you just said she was Super Blue Mage.
Only when she's around Roxas for long periods of time do her powers activate.
Why do I always get stuck with the icky jobs?
Axel's best scene.
Axel.
Shion. What are you gonna do?
I've decided that I have to go back to where I belong.
Well, to be honest, I always felt that was best right from the very beginning.
He knew that she had to return to Sora.
Really bugs me.
Right?
Something about this just stinks.
Still love this. It's arrangement of another promise.
But how do you know that?
Yeah, the thing is that when Axel agrees with her right here, you're not supposed to realize that he's agreeing with her in that respect. You're meant to think...
Also, this is Shion's theme. It's called Fading Memory.
Promise.
You're meant to think that when Axel agrees with her right there, that he's saying that she should come back with him back to the organization.
Problem?
To be to be the trio again. But you can do whatever when you in actuality, he's agreeing that she should go back to Sora.
Go on, you just keep running. But I'll always be there to bring you back.
And it still took everything out of him to do this.
Why you gotta cause me so much trouble?
This is what happens when you fight a Keyblade wielder.
Also a Blue Mage.
A Blue Mage Keyblade wielder, the deadliest of foes.
You know what the first magic Shion was able to use was?
What?
Fire. When she first joins you, she had already been hanging around Axel. But when she first joins you and can't use the Keyblade, she's using fire spells.
Yeah.
Decent fire spells, too.
After going on missions with Demix, she can use blizzard spells.
Where did I think I could go?
She never learns thunder spells because she's never been around Larxene.
Never had a chance.
And here we are.
Shion.
Just gonna ominously give you ice cream. It's threatening.
Well, yeah, she poisoned it. She poisoned it in an effort to make him weaker. Problem is, he didn't need any of it. He just sat there holding it.
I'm out of time.
Also, if you notice something about her robe,
she's gone back to the male character model.
Yes.
Even if I'm not.
She's
ready,
now Sora's character model.
I have to make this choice.
Why didn't we ever have a game where Sora went undercover? So that would have been cool.
Well, because you know what? You know what I noticed? So the theme of all the side games is memories.
Who do you see?
Seems to be, yeah.
If you see somebody else's face, a boy's face, then that means I'm almost ready. This puppet will have to play her part. Roxas, this is him. It's Sora.
It's really effeminate Sora with a high-pitched voice.
This is Sora. Before he hit puberty.
Yeah, this is Sora after taking a whole bunch of estrogen pills.
You're next, Roxas. I have to make you a part of me, too. Don't you see? This is why I was created.
Damn ghosts.
Am I wrong in thinking all the side games reference memories?
They seem to be, yes.
No, like, literally every in-between game references memories. Which probably explains why you're constantly going to the Kingdom Hearts 1 worlds.
Aside from Breath by Sleep.
Breath by Sleep has, like, one or two different worlds. Fun fact, this scene did not exist in the first version of this.
Could we watch the credits once the game ends?
We are planning to, yes.
Awesome.
But yeah, no, this fight scene was not in the original, and they...
I recognize.
It could not be in the... It could not be in the PS3 version, because they could only patch the PS4 version.
Neat. A little bit jarring going from the reveal, and then suddenly it's over.
And yet they still cut out the Saix fight, which I... is just as important as this fight. Because it showed Roxas' desperation.
I don't know. I mean, you could assume that he was desperate, and honestly, you know he's more powerful than Saix. That's just not debated.
Yeah. If you're wondering how Roxas stayed in the air like that, he can fly.
Okay.
He legitimately can fly.
Was that one of Sora's combat finishers?
Yes.
Sure was.
Fun fact, Sora can do everything Roxas can, he just doesn't.
Aside from the wheel... Well, I don't know.
No, he can do a wheel.
Naturally, though, without...
yes,
without
naturally.
Driving?
He can do it without drive forms. He can naturally do a wheel. He just doesn't.
Who are you?
Yeah, wouldn't want an OP Sora, would we?
It's weird.
I mean, Roxas is still stronger than really Sora. Important. Canonically.
Well, I know, but, I mean, we wouldn't want an OP
stronger,
Sora.
Stronger, but not as versatile. Roxas.
Who did this to you?
No.
And now we hear fading memory in its entirety.
It was my choice.
Am I the one who did this to you? He says, forgetting what he did just like 2 seconds ago.
That's because he's forgetting everything to do
with
Shion.
Yeah, literally starting the retcon device. And
let Zemnis have his memory put his brain put everything in the recycle bin and hit empty.
Sora. Yeah, pretty much. literally what happens here.
By the way, those are memories.
His brain's like, yeah, can't remember that. That can't be good.
Those are actually memories because they reuse this effect in a later game for the exact same thing.
All those hearts that I've captured. Kingdom hearts. Set them free.
Kingdom hearts. Free them?
It's too late. You need to undo my mistakes. But you can't let Zemnis have Kingdom Hearts. You can't.
Yeah, I'm afraid, Zeon, he's not going to remember anything you're saying right now.
Goodbye.
He's not going to remember it for, like, 3 years.
See you again.
After which it's too late, because Sora's already taken care of it.
I got to meet you.
Yeah.
Oh. And of course...
I love Axel as an afterthought. Oh, right, yeah, no, Axel too.
You know that guy.
You know that guy with the red hair.
Never
he's cool.
Forget. That's the truth.
No. Shion. Who else will I have ice cream with?
That's what you're worried about.
The most important part, the ice cream.
Can't forget the ice cream. Can't.
I mean, there's half of Roxas' diary is ice cream.
Yeah, forget everything else.
Yeah. Also, wait, Roxas does have a diary. Did the diary just get erased?
Doesn't it just say
probably
something at the start of 3 or 2? I mean,
Shion.
No. That's Sora's journal.
Okay.
Oh, wait, yeah, no, you're right, because in Chain of Memories, Naminé has the power to wipe Sora's journal, so that means Roxas' diary got wiped as well, didn't it? Right?
Yeah.
Just saying thank Naminé at the start of KH2?
No, it happened in Chain of Memories. The journal got wiped, remember?
I don't remember Chain of Memories all the way through all the plot. Well, so.
Well, yeah, it gets Jiminy's journal gets wiped the moment Sora goes to sleep after Chain of Memories because that's when the memories start getting deleted.
Not just that, it got wiped when he first entered of his previous adventure.
Yeah,
So Naminé can wipe the journal just by being connected to Sora.
Yeah, the KH1 entries got deleted the moment he stepped inside, and then the Castle Oblivion memories got deleted from the journal the moment he went to sleep.
Yep. The interesting thing is, in the game, this scene, dual-wielding Roxas actually fucking sucks.
Isn't this scene, like, a full,
yeah, it was another side, another story.
Another side, another story, yeah.
I stand by dual wield Roxas is still very fun to play as in mission mode.
Yeah, he just fucking... In mission mode, yeah, but otherwise he just fucking sucks. Like, attack power-wise, he is bad.
Yeah.
Of course he gets the Oblivion, because that's Riku's Keyblade for Sora, isn't it?
It's the one that represents him, yes.
The Oathkeeper's Kairi.
What?
Now you've said in the past that all these Neo Shatters have 1 HP, right, Selegna?
Correct.
Despite that, I think Riku would have still taken one shot at all of them anyways.
Oh yeah, so would Roxas. Like, canonically dual wielding Roxas is super, super strong.
Who are you? What does it matter? I'm here for you. Why are you trying to stop me? Because I want back the rest of Sora's memories. Sora? Enough about Sora! Do you have some kind of plan? I'll set Kingdom Hearts free. Then everything will be the way it was. She'll come back. And the three of us can be together again. You mean Shion? It's a struggle just to remember the name now. Either way, I can't let you go doing anything crazy. I'm freeing Kingdom Hearts, and I'm going to find Sora. I want Shion back. I want my life back! If you try and
that's make not gonna happen.
Kingdom Hearts, the last thing not for you'll a while. Get is your life back. The organization will destroy you. Enough!
Yeah. Sir, you're in over your head.
Why? Why do you have the key?
Well, that's his name, Sir In Over His Head.
Here's the funny thing. They cut out that entire fight.
Yep. And then they did. Oh, okay.
Would have been nice to have a slightly longer clash between Riku and Roxas, yeah. I'll be interested to see
I'm sorry, I thought I was muted.
I'll be interested to know how many HP bars Riku has in this fight.
I can remember the exact amount.
I'm willing to bet it's like 5 or so. Because HP bars are like the easiest way for gameplay to identify how strong an enemy is. Like, the more HP bars an enemy has, the more powerful they are.
Come on, Sora. I thought you were stronger than that.
Huh? Get real. Look which one of us is winning.
So it's true. You really are his nobody. Guess Diz was right after all.
What are you
talking? How many did you say?
I am me.
5.
You're wrong.
Nobody else.
Is it more or less?
It's more.
Then I'm gonna say 8.
Close.
Please, you have
it's 9, isn't it?
8.5.
How many times? 8.5.
Okay. Beat you?
All right.
The random super strong heartless have more HP than Riku. Choice.
What? That is weird.
They are large, tanky boys. Riku's just.
I'm referring to like the Zip Slasher series of heartless, which only exists in 3, 5, 8 over 2. So do a bunch of ones, actually. Like, the giant helicopter enemies that are giant, like, mages, they only exist in 3, 5, 8 over 2. All the recolors for the dark sides only exist in 3, 5, 8 over 2 as well.
I'm gonna squeeze the life out of you.
So close to being nothing personnel.
I have accepted it.
You're talking to an unconscious boy right now, Riku. I don't think anyone cares.
Maybe he just needed to say it for himself. He's just like, I must say this for myself. Now watch as Xion fades, the cutscene starts to act like it wouldn't have mattered if she was there or not. It still would have gone on normally.
Diz, he could feel Sora.
Oh, he told you.
He most definitely could. For a bit.
Ridiculous. Nobody cannot feel anything.
God. Yeah, Diz is an idiot.
Sora, things might have been different.
If the organization hadn't gotten to Roxas first, what would have happened?
I assume Diz would have ended him and just made his plan go faster.
I came from Probably. You and Sora.
But then Xion wouldn't exist.
Because you wouldn't
the
have
same
to.
Way that I am
yeah.
Sora. You'll forget me.
It wouldn't matter if Diz got Roxas first, because then he could have ended him and then the memories would go back and move.
Memories of you and me.
Everything would have been a moot point.
Forever. Yeah, but then it would screw things up later in the timeline.
Well, no, because the timeline would have corrected itself to make things go the way it needs to for everything to work out.
This is true. And this is the first day of Kingdom Hearts 2 here.
First day of Roxas' last week of summer vacation.
Yep.
The first day of a 3-hour prologue that is goddamn annoyingly long.
Another dream about him.
Like, I'm serious. The prologue for KH2 is way long. I mean, unless you're playing it on the PS2 emulator or the PS3 emulator. I don't think the PS3 emulator has fast forward. So I think you can only do it on the PS2 emulator.
Hit the beach.
I think that's the only way you can speed us up. Fuse fast forward.
Only 7 days to go, and then my summer vacation's over.
You have no idea how truthful that is, Roxas.
Mm-hmm.
So I actually recognized one of the musicians on this game's credits.
Oh, which one?
His name is Taku Sakakibara, and he's the strings supervisor for the orchestra for the score. He arranged the string section. And his name is Taku Sakakibara. He formerly was a musician for Konami's music division.
Oh.
You ever heard of the Beatmania and Dance Dance Revolution games?
Yeah.
You know, the soundtracks from those come from a combination of licensed tracks and in-house artists?
Makes sense.
And Taku, going by the acronym TAK, T-A-Q, is did a lot of music for Dance Dance Revolution and Beatmania 2DX. I've got a couple of his albums. They're really good. So I'm hoping to see his name. I don't think it's listed like this. I think it's in the credit in the staff.
The scroll, yeah, in the scroll.
Staff roll, yeah. Should be pretty close to this section. Alexis Smith? Really? Cool.
Who was that?
No, my name is Alex Smith.
Oh. Well, Smith is like the most common American last name.
Yeah, I know. But Alexis.
It's still cool.
Alex.
Oh, yeah.
I think he was in Street Fighter Days number 2, you might have been on hand for Burton.
Oh yeah, Ark.
Yes?
I'm kind of sick of grinding in 358 over 2.
Yeah, it seems like you would get to that. Yeah.
At this point, I'm probably going to just cheat in every panel. I already have all the most broken ones just from completing the challenge missions. If anything, it'll just make the game go faster. What?
How long have you been grinding for, then?
A lot. A while. I've been grinding the entire time we've been playing since I woke up at 8.
Oh my goodness.
I'm just cheating in the panels at this point.
That's probably worth
it. I love the gameplay. I hate the grinding.
That's valid.
There should be sound section.
Mission mode is a lot of fun with friends.
There should be Taku Sakaki Bada. This should be a strings. That might be under a third party contractor. So. Or event animation planning. String section recording. THQ Taku. That's him.
Oh, that's cool.
String arranger. Gakdan. That might be one of his pseudonyms. Under, yeah. I mean, you guys won't recognize the name, but it's I'll post some of his music. It's really good.
Mhm. But yeah, no. It's just. Why? Why did they make 358 over 2 so grindy? Even Recoded wasn't this grindy. Mostly because Recoded is just super easy as a game. Super fun to play, but super easy to beat. Even on Proud Mode.
Can you hear that knocking?
What?
That's 3D knocking on your door because it's coming for you.
A 3D is super fun to play though.
It is. I'm just saying, it may be even more grindy.
Oh no! Don't worry, they got rid of the grind in the remake.
Yeah, it's not that bad. even in the original 3DS version wasn't that bad.
Yeah, especially if you don't interact with the Dream Eaters at all, which you don't have to. Are the ones that you start with.
Well, no, you can use the cheat method of just starting a mini game with them and just getting the points that starting and then quickly quitting and getting.
Oh, they fixed that in the PS4. They fixed that in the remake.
No, you can do that in the remake.
Oh, that must have been introduced in the remake then.
Yep. And you just get points that way to go across the grids. All right, and with that, we are done with Kingdom Hearts 358 over 2 days, the movie. So I want to thank everybody for watching, and we'll be back next year for at the beginning of the year. We'll probably start with Cage 2 as is proper, and then move on to Birth by Sleep, and then Recoded movie and game.
There is three in the pipeline. Where's Cage 3 in the pipeline?
Oh god, we're nowhere close. Yeah. We're nowhere close. We have two, Birth by Sleep, Recoded, 3D, Birth by, it's, we've got like five games before we get to 3.
Yeah, 3 is the year after next.
Yeah,
because we're doing three games.
What I've been waiting for.
Yeah, the problem is we're doing three games a year. Unless we somehow get through those three really fast, which there's no guarantee we will. We just plan on three a year.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right.
Anyways, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
Yep.
In about a month or so.